make it. The game loaded up here. Welcome back to another episode of Minecraft Dungeons.
Minecraft Dungeons. Press any button.
We're back here, level 10. With my level 10 fighting. If you guys did not see in the last episode, we unlocked the mysterious merchant. It gives you a random weapon. We find a chest. There's a gift wrapper, which is kind of useless for me. That's to send you send out items to other players when you're playing multiplayer, which I don't got no fans. We completed the soggy swamp, the pumpkin pastures, and we unlocked the soggy cave. We also got a couple more ender eyes while completing those. So we're gonna go back. We're gonna go into the soggy cave. Into default 4. If you guys enjoy this episode and other episodes, go ahead and find me on Twitch. I'm at little_live. If you guys are watching this on Twitch and enjoy this, hit that follow button. Right up here is my follower goal. Go ahead and hit the follow button. My goal is 10 followers. I'm hoping I can get to that. I do this every day for around like 6, 7 p.m. Minus a couple days. I will be back on tomorrow around the same time, hopefully. Depending on how busy my work is, because this does not pay the bills. I hope it does. And I hope you guys will help me get through that. But right now, I'm stuck to what I can do on the days that I do actually have to work, because I got this today. So, it would be really helpful if you guys hit that follow button. If you're on YouTube, hit that subscribe, that like button, and just show your support. If you get to 10 followers, I'll do like an extra long stream. Probably not a 12-hour stream, because I figured out that I can't do that. So I might be doing an 8-hour stream one day. But go ahead, hit that like, follow button, and we'll see how this goes. Gotta love this, right? Jesus. Well, not even 5 minutes the stream and I'm already dying. Takes a while. Hey. No climb. This is just gonna be the same as last time, so watch me die again. Just had a battle here. Now doing that should unlock this. Which unlocks a massive jet. Which brings me back up here. Which just allows me to return to the boat. Oh, this is a quicker map. Not that hard. Minus me dying. But it just has to be those witches and those creepers. Totem of Regeneration. This handcrafted wooden figurine radiates the warmth like the crackling campfire, healing those who gather around it. This is 182 healed with 25 second cooldown. I have to go with the Iron one. Let's replace that with a soul heal and let's enchant. Alright. Illogent's Bane. Attacks deal extra damage to Illogent. Kind of helpful. Freezing. Slows mobs after hit for 3 seconds. Useful. Thundering. Has a 30% chance of dealing summon lightning to strike nearby mobs. Enemies. Useful. Guarding strike. When you defeat a mob, you are given a temporary shield that reduces damage by 50%. So freezing, thundering, and there we go. Alright, let's check the build of merchant. 25 and 20. Reduction and 20% weapon damage boost or compared to salvage that. Frenzied while you are less than half health, your melee and ranged attack speeds are increased. A food reserves when using a healing potion. You also create food items. Follow that and use the remaining two. Alright. I'm gonna mute myself for just 1 second to open anything. My dinner has just arrived, so I'm going to eat it while playing. So we're skipping all these because they are DLC stuff. That last one was a daily challenge. And we're going to go straight into the Redstone Mines. Which is going to be so fun. Here we go.
There are unsettling rumblings in the mountains of the overworld. Whispered rumors say the Illagers are building something dreadful far beneath these ancient mines. Something of soot, metal, and flame. Only a hero such as yourself could brave the cavernous underground and uncover the truth.
So if you didn't see that minecart, if it goes by and you're on the tracks, you get hit. Which is not bad, because it takes out like half the damage. This will generate new mobs, as you just saw. So the quicker you get them out, the better. And we all know me, if the quest is telling me to go one way, go the other way. Also, the minecarts are not biased, so it will hurt mobs as well. When you level up, you get full health. Full health and another too. I did like an 8-minute recording, but ended up trashing it because it was just a complete mess. I found out that over here you can give yourself a cape and a little animal hat. I thought it was the cutest thing ever. I don't know if people on stream saw it, but... the little animal doesn't really do anything, it just falls down. That was 4 mobs taken out. Mobs, enemies, same thing. If y'all ask. Again, getting hit by one of those will take out like half your... take out half your health. I'm just hungry. And it's currently like 8 o'clock in my time. villages are really gonna help. My merchant, not the mystery one, but the luxury merchant. You can unlock more of their slots by defeating more mobs. Bring villagers, sorry. Mystery merchant is enchanted mobs. Defeat more enchanted mobs. Finding chests and following the path is the main reason why I keep the map open. It's not exactly too distracting for me, so I'm able to do it without a problem. Y'all saw that, right? Like, it just straight up didn't do anything. Why? That's certainly not how that goes. If you see that little... Ooh, our blacksmith. It's over here. I'm trying to block out. Here's my blacksmith. He'll allow me to upgrade my artifacts. Every 3 missions is a level. And that's 3 missions.
So the rumors were true. The Illagers are building a dreadful forge under the mountain.
I got another fireworks arrow. It has the explosive power of TNT combined with the high velocity movement of an arrow. What could possibly go wrong? Yeah. Welcome to the chat. May you join what, though? As you can see here, that this is more powerful. Unfortunately, I honestly don't allow strangers to just join my game. I do apologize for that, but I do like playing by myself. Maybe later down in the road, but as for right now, just doing it by myself would be helpful. A little bit more helpful. Okay. more powerful, but slower. What does my mystery button have? Random item. Random item. That is. Not helpful. See what this recommends me to do. Minus all that. The Fiery Forge. Why not? We're roughly halfway through my recommended time.
The Fiery Forge, where the Arch Illager builds monstrous machines that devastate the villages of the Overworld. He must be stopped. Strike with everything you've got and raise this forge to ruins.
I do apologize, it's not the fact that you might be better than me, or something like that. It's more the fact that, that I don't exactly have that best of communication skills and best of friends, so. Because you can tell that I just started so hard on that. I might get angry, just so you know. I remember this level, and I absolutely hate the part that's going to be coming up soon. So this might not be safe for kids. I tried to make all my videos friendly for kids. Like, that's right. If you guys allow your kids to watch people like this, games like this. I couple of my friends think I don't think I shouldn't be in at the job I am now because I deal with customers. Because when I honestly don't care enough, I just be myself. And I do have to talk about it. Most of the time it's stuff like it's nothing when I go on tours, but you never know when you're gonna get a nice chest. And XP is XP, so can't really go. So much happening. That's honestly not the part I thought it was. I also might be thinking of the wrong map too. Oh my god. Thank you. focusing here is, if you guys can't tell, it's a lot going on. Let me get there. Watch this! well, it's just absolute chaos. This is like a bigger redstone golem. I know that for a fact. And it can be annoying. Last time that I tried to defeat it, there was a glitch and opened up the gate, so I didn't actually defeat it. I left some loot. How did I leave some loot? It literally looks like a beacon on my screen. That's fine. So yeah, the last time I defeated it, there was a glitch, and I opened up the door before I finished defeating it, so I just bolted through all of this. Like, nope, I'm done. Get me to the door. And in its eyes, I completed it. because I made it to the door.
The Fiery Forge is destroyed. The war machines of the Illagers have been smashed.
This is for the bow. Dripping poison. When use health force. When you use a health potion, you are given a quiver of poison arrows. Artifact charge. Whenever you use an artifact, your next few attacks become charged. Smite it. Increase damage against the undead. Artifact charge. Let's just do one. Weakening. This is for my sword. Your attacks decrease the attack damage of the nearby mobs for 5 seconds. Stunning. Chance to temporarily stun enemies. Or echo. Some of your attacks can be followed up by another attack in rapid succession. We want to do that. Streaming tomorrow, roughly around 6-7 o'clock, depending on how long it takes me at work. I might do it even quicker, sooner, because I don't have to cook tomorrow. I'm thinking we can either do Minecraft, my Lonely Island series, or Stardew Valley. I have a nice little Blackfield Farm. Can't remember off the top of my head. Series going. I don't think I got too far into it. I will also break these down into an hour-long videos. So I hope you enjoyed this. If you're watching this live on Twitch, I post everything onto YouTube just in case you guys missed an episode or just joined and likes to see what I'm doing. Go ahead and head over there. It's Willow_Slive. Hit the subscribe button, hit the like button on those videos that you like if you're watching this on Twitch. I'm trying to get to a follower goal right up here. 10 followers. If I do manage, I'll do an extra long stream, probably 8-10 hours, hopefully. So let's get to that follower goal, please. If you're watching this on YouTube, go ahead and find me on Twitch. I do these live on Twitch at Willow_Slive. So go ahead and find me there, please. And hit that subscribe and like button, please. Thank you.